It is so very cool, and indeed I am honored to be able to introduce Heather Schwartz McDonough, this year's co-distinguished Terrapin. I had the good fortune of having had Heather as a student in my J360 broadcast writing and reporting class all the way back to the spring of 2002. It is hard to believe it is a few years ago. I've had the absolute pleasure of watching Heather as her career has grown and her family has expanded. Heather's post-college career has included stops at WTTG, CSN Mid-Atlantic, the MLB Network, and of course, NBC Fort Washington, where she is now senior sports producer. Mike Goldrick, NBC Fort's news director, who was here but had to get back to the station, tells me that Heather is smart, creative, a hard worker, and, this is Mike's words, leads peacock. Mike says Heather has a real knack for understanding that a sports segment in a local TV newscast has to appeal to the viewer who doesn't watch games, but likes a good story and appreciates when the hometown is winning. What immediately jumped out at me when I got to know Heather, and it's what I always recall, is her enthusiasm, her smarts, her dedication, and her ability to mix it up when it came to sports. No one got the drop on Heather. For Heather, it did all really begin here, like Megan, at WNUC Sports. I reached out to a couple of other alums and former students of mine, including former WNUC Sports Director Josh Maurer, now the voice of UMass football and basketball, as well as the Pawtucket Red Sox. Josh says the best adjective for Heather during her college days is appropriately enough, fearless. Josh writes, Heather came to Maryland knowing she wanted to do broadcast sports, and whether or not she knew it, she was walking right into a man's world. In his 4 years of working for WNUC Sports, Josh says, you can count on one hand the number of females who attempted to earn a spot on the broadcast crew for any sport. Heather was the only one who not only made a crew, but also stuck with the department season after season, working on her craft and eventually rising to the leadership ranks. Josh goes on to say that he can only imagine how intimidating it must have been for Heather to try and be a part of what was essentially then a boys-only club. While women are now increasingly being heard doing play-by-play and color commentary, 17 years ago, it was pretty much a rarity. And it is clear Heather didn't care about those obstacles, but fought to take her place in the press box. Another alum, a friend of Heather's as well, Eitan Horowitz, now the senior lead editor for Apple News, writes me that Heather is one of those people where you could mention any sports team, athlete, or topic, and she could speak for 5 minutes or more about it. On a personal note, Heather is just one terrific individual. She's a standout professional, a wife and partner, a terrific loving mom to Maddie and Nathan, who you might have heard As Josh Maurer puts it, Heather is a great and loyal friend who has a knack for finding a way to make anyone she knows feel important. Perhaps that in itself is the secret to Heather's success. But I think even more than that is the quote that Heather has on her Facebook page, which I think provides even more insight. It is from A League of Their Own, and it goes like this. It's supposed to be hard. If it wasn't hard, everyone would do it. The hard is what makes it great. And Heather, you are truly a great Merrill alum and a friend, and so deserving of this distinguished Terrapin Award. Congrats.
Team, and that was pretty cool. Tim has two from ESPN, that's a whole other thing. But distinguished Terrapin, that is a pretty cool honor. Growing up in New York and New Jersey, it's easy to fall in love with sports, love, hate, when it comes to the Mets and the Jets for obvious reasons. I remember checking out box scores with my dad and watching the NBA on NBC because the Knicks always seemed to be on. They were always playing the Bulls. And somewhere along the line, I thought, hey, I want to cover sports as a career. Coming to Maryland changed my life. It put me on the path to where I am now in my career. From obviously first enrolling in the journalism school here to calling the games at MUC, then staying in town for my first internship at Fox 5 and then my first job out of college there. Nathan's choking on apple juice right now. and then obviously my stops at CSN, where I worked with Joe, who was my boss over there, and I'm always indebted to. And then at MLB Network, where I work with some fantastic people as well. And then ultimately to be where I am now at NBC4, first as a producer, and then our executive producer, Jeff Greenberg, left several years ago to go to the Pac-12 Network, and into my lap fell the running the department. I stepped right in, and now for several years I've been a senior sports producer there. The best station in Washington, NBC4. Before I continue, I wanted to also say I was lucky to be at Maryland during a great time, a great sports run. I mean, Gary was here for the Final Four, the national title. I was here, three bowl games. So I'm forever grateful to Ralph Regent and Gary Williams for bringing such joy and excitement to the campus during the time I was here. As Sue kind of mentioned in her speech, some of the guys alluded to, being a woman in the sports world, it's commonplace now, but it hasn't always been, and I'm grateful to all the women who broke those barriers for me, who allowed me to be here where I am today. And I'm lucky. I never really encountered sexism or a lot of that kind of stuff, since I've been in the industry. I'm very lucky. And I'll say this, though. I have worked hard. I've always wanted to be taken seriously to make sure that I'm treated as an equal. And I'd like to think that through that hard work, I've been rewarded with the respect from my colleagues, friends, and all of those who know me, whether it's in a personal or professional environment. The love for sports, and that's the easy part. The passion for what I do, that's also the easy part. The hard part, that's balancing. as many working moms and dads can attest to, and we are right in the thick of it right now, but obviously what makes it possible is having a supportive, loving partner who is there with you every step of the way, and Tim is there with Maddie on his lap. Hi, Tim. He has been battling them all day today, so he's been with me to help me thrive as a wife, a mom, a professional, and a person. He's a Newhouse guy, but he's not one of those snooty ones. He's a very cool, brave guy, and again, he's been doing yeoman's work with these two today. So again, I kind of skipped a couple lines, but to thrive as a wife, mom, professional, and person, he's the best. So thank you. I think Nathan's singing right now. Maybe it's the Maryland fight song or something. I'm happy to have Maddie and Nathan here today, along with my uncle, who came down from Manhattan. My parents were here last week from New Jersey watching the kids, so they couldn't make the trip again, but my uncle is here, keeping Nathan in check over there. My parents were FaceTiming, but somewhere along the way that ended, but I gotta thank them, Marlene and Jim Schwartz up in New Jersey, and again, Mike, who was here earlier, our news director at Election Day, had to get back to the station, but I really appreciate the sport. Local sports these days, we're striving and just to continue to stay relevant and survive in this, what we have going on, where you can find news and everything on your phone, and so how to stay relevant and connect with people, and we're trying, and I like to think we're still doing a pretty good job at it, so I take a lot of pride in the fact that we still have a functioning sports department, and one that is still managing to thrive. we had Sue with that beautiful introduction. Thank you, Sue, I've stayed in contact with since my days in school. Alan Reed, who, you know, congrats on your honor as well, who was an advisor obviously here when I was in school. The Povich family, you know, for all that you do for this program, for this school, thank you. And Megan and Alex, both former interns at NBC4. It makes me, and obviously at WNBC as well, so to see them doing so well and being so successful, what they're learning here at the school and then taking that into the professional world, I have no doubt that when they graduate, we're going to hear their names and see big things from them. So Megan and Alex, congrats on your awards as well. And I think that's it. So thank you all again. And thank you for listening to these kids in the back. But you guys have been pretty good. They like to applaud. I appreciate this honor. And I'm thrilled, distinguished Terrapin. So thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much.